Hello! In this video, I will show you how to construct a system of differential equations for interacting populations. A client wants an aquarium with two kinds of fish, rainbow fish and gouramis. The client insists on a kind of gourami that is rather aggressive and sometimes eats a rainbow fish. We are going to construct a model to simulate what happens. Let me say immediately that the numbers we are going to use here are made up. We do not really know what would happen in such an aquarium. So this is a purely speculative model. One of the advantages of mathematical modeling is that no fish will be harmed by it. First, we will consider what happens with the separate species. Okay, let's put the rainbow fish in this virtual aquarium. The model for the population by itself is this differential equation. You see that the aquarium is large enough for a healthy population of 100 rainbow fish. As the client does not sell any fish, there is no harvesting term. This is the graph of the solution. The population grows logistically from 20 to 100 fish. The gourami are modeled to do less well by themselves. We assume that without small fish to prey on, their birth rate is lower than their death rate. The net growth rate is minus a quarter. So, without prey, the number of gouramis would decrease exponentially from 5 to 0. Now we put the 5 gourami in the tank with the 20 rainbow fish. Here are the equations. The gouramis will eat the rainbow fish. So a negative term has to be included in the equation for P. The gourami population will benefit from eating the rainbow fish, so a positive term should be added to the equation for G. For these interaction terms, we start simple. Both terms are modeled as a constant times the product of P and G. Maybe this does the trick, and we can always do another modeling cycle when it doesn't. So, what could be an appropriate values for alpha and beta? First, we consider the alpha for the rainbow fish. Let us go back to the balance equation. How does P change during a time interval of length delta t? The first term is the limited growth term without interaction. The second term is the interaction term. It describes the number of rainbow fish that are eating between time t and time t plus delta t. So, if you leave out the delta t, alpha times p times g is the number of rainbow fish eaten per day. Let us take alpha equal to 4%. This means that each gourami eats 4% of the rainbow fish per day. If there are 25 rainbow fish in the tank and one gourami, the gourami would eat one rainbow fish a day. If there are 25 rainbow fish, 5 gouramis would eat 5 times as many rainbow fish a day. So that scales as you would expect. Now back to one gourami. If we take 100 rainbow fish, the gourami supposedly gets more aggressive with all these rainbow fish invading its territory, and the rainbow fish will be easier to catch. So the gourami now eats 4 rainbow fish per day. You see that when there are very many rainbow fish, the model does not hold up. When there are 1,000 rainbow fish, the poor gourami would have to eat 40 rainbow fish a day. So the conclusion is that when P is high, this model has to be improved. The capacity for our tank is only 100 rainbow fish, so we are probably safe. Now the equation for the gouramis. Here also we go back to the difference equation. The interaction term now describes the extra growth in the number of gouramis now that they have extra food. This growth could be caused by additional eggs being hatched, or you could say that because the gouramis have eaten the rainbow fish, they die later. We set the value of beta at 0.008. You can interpret that as follows. Each gourami eats 4% of the rainbow fish each day. And for every 5 rainbow fish that a gourami eats, 1 extra gourami is gained. 4% divided by 5 equals 0.008. The two differential equations form a system. The equations are coupled. In the differential equation for P, there's a term with G, and vice versa. So the equations have to be solved together as a system. In this video, you have seen a simple predator-prey model and how the interaction terms in it can be interpreted. In the course, you will learn how to approximate the solutions of this system numerically and to determine the type of the equilibrium points.